believe, for Greensbury this year. Of course, Reece Boyden has 41 as well, sitting second on the overall tally. So, yeah, it's going to be a pretty big ask for the Heidelberg defenders.
And just looking already early on, Shrywood has gone back to Boyden. Nick Miller on Josh Riddle. I think he's already looking for a change of matchup there. Far too big there with Josh Riddle be, so they've already made the change, and now it's Miller going to, looks like, Josh Grubb, and Coulson starting back on Luke Stanton. So a bit of a surprise, the big fella going in defence early on. Luby, the man to Stella, says the umpire holds the ball off and we're ready to go. Greensboro up against Heidelberg, round 13 action in the Northern Football League.
Mick Finn's the man going up against Mickey Hooper. It is Finn who won it down. It wasn't a clean one down to the path for Gaylard, but a big tackle is laid on Pianto straight away, so we will have a secondary stoppage to kick off the grand final rematch.
Division 1, big game here. First versus fourth. Very muddy War Memorial Park. The rain has come and gone from the reserves game. It's probably going to come back again, though, as the forecast has said. The handball towards centre-half forward. There's no clean possession there, so we'll get a second ball up just ahead of these centre circles here at War Memorial. It's Mick Finn doing the early ruck work against Mick Hooper. The two Micks, two of the best ruckmen in Division 1. Hooper got the tap forward. It went to Stead. Stead wrapped up in a big tackle from Michael Luby, and there'll be another stoppage.
Kieran Andrew with the job on Jason Rogers. Jason Rogers really hurt Heidelberg in a couple of games last year, but most notably the grand final, where he and Hooper were the two dominant players on the ground.
Hooper down to Stellis. Mullins in there, taken the ground by Cookson, and there'll be a full stoppage.
Good aggressive start to the game. Plenty of bodies flying around everywhere in the centre square at the moment here at War Memorial Park. And Hooper winning down from that ruck contest. Kieran Andrew, a little handball out to Young. He got wrapped up in a huge tackle. The umpire said, is it going to be holding the ball?
Yes.
Yes, it will be. It's going to be a Greensboro ball at between wing and half back. Looking for their first forward half entry of the day. Little short chip pass.
Jordan
comes in the path of Perry. Playing his first game for Greensboro. Now he lost one in the direction of Hooper. Good work there by Finn to get a fist on it. And then he went back in. Good second effort there by Mick Finn to win the ball back for his team. Then a little handball out to Cookson. Now McCook, and he's able to get it back here for Greensboro. A little dribbling ball inside the forward half. Luby picks it up and swings it back where it came from again. Marking contest was made by a couple of Heidelberg players. Nice work by Fowler to bring it to ground. Now going in hard. Handball out there from Stone. Trying to get a handball chain going. On hands and knees, here is Gaylard. Working hard, plenty of Heidelberg players, and a lot of numbers around the ball here, one of which is McLinden, who lays a big tackle. Perry in there as well.
Missed an opportunity, didn't they, Heidelberg? The handball there by Jack Ryan just missed the target. They had numbers streaming forward, but the handball not to advantage, and Greensboro able to get numbers back now, make a congestion and make for a clearance or a stoppage inside Heidelberg's attacking half.
Finn double-fisted that down to Gaylard. Gaylard swings one on the right boot inside forward 50, but getting back there was, I think it was Adrian Cataldo in defence, taking a nice mark there for Greensboro. Comes back out the near side looking for Hooper. Couldn't take the mark, so Heidelberg get it back. And again, inside 50 they go. Can they get a mark this time? No, they can't. Cataldo again.
And he switches the ball now. And Greensboro have runners looking for the switch. Brent Ryan's a man on the outside now. Can get and go. He's taken the mark, played on quickly. He was wrapped up, though, as he kicked. It's going to be a turnover. No, getting inside there was McQuilkin, offering support. Gave it off to McClendon, back to McQuilkin. The Max getting involved there. Wide kick now, looking for Stanton. He was caught behind, and Ben Curtin did well for Heidelberg. Fists it out of bounds with a throw in, sent to wing. Greensboro clicking to the club room end of the ground in this first term. No scores just yet. We have gone 3 minutes in the opening quarter.
So I'm fine to throw it in. Out of wing here at War Memorial. And it is Hooper winning it down. Got a little bit of contact from Mick Finn. Now it's McQuilkin giving it to Josh Riddle, who tumbles a high one into full forward. Rywood and Boyden, good spoil by Boyden, brings it to ground. Rywood's going to have to be clean here. He just ushers the ball cleverly towards the boundary line, out for a boundary throw-in.
So only the second inside 50 entry for Greensboro this afternoon. The first one was efficiently swept up upon by Michael Luby. Here in the forward pocket, 20 metres around from their goal. No advantage in the ruck contest there. Heidelberg will get the clearance up towards centre half back. Here goes Cookson. He just hacks that one onto the boot and it spills out towards centre wing. Perry runs onto it, tries to paddle it to his own advantage, but he can't gather in the wet conditions. He might get a second chance here, not before Matthew Hyde comes through. Handball to the outside. Some of the young players getting involved here for Greensboro. Perry is there, as is Callaway, and that one's gone to ground, and there'll be a ball up on centre wing. Near side of the ground, about 10 or 15 metres inside from the boundary line, probably just favouring Greensboro's half of the ground. Over the top goes Hooper, taps that one down to Fowler, tries to handball underground to his own advantage, Didn't really come off though for Fowler, so Heidelberg will get it away through Cookson again. The clearance out from the pack. Perry got a fingertip to it, couldn't control. Miller now off to a teammate in Stone. He lobs that one up towards half forward, coming in from the side. No mark taken there from Greensboro. Again, ball hits the ground. There'll be a lot of that today. And there's been a free kick out of that pack, has there? Or the umpire called for it? No, the umpire's called for it, so there'll be a ball up just on the front edge of the centre square. Almost at centre half forward here for the Tigers.
So 5 minutes gone, still no score, and is Hooper winning it down once again into the path of a teammate. Couldn't pick it up. Stead, another teammate picked it up and is wrapped up. A lot of numbers around this footy, as we said. Early stages here in the first quarter, zero plays zero.
Around centre half forward, still. Finn doing the ruck work against Hooper. Hooper got the tap. Didn't go down to a teammate though, so no tap to advantage. And again, the ball hits the ground. Underneath that one is Pianto. Flying the flag, the final bastion of Chrome Domes for Heidelberg today, with no Jason Kennedy in the side. Still at centre half forward. It's going to be Hooper again doing the ruck work against Finn. Finn this time got the tap down. Cookson came through, couldn't take it off Callaway, and Cookson slung his man out of the pack, so there'll be a free kick. It's actually going to go Cookson's way. I thought he was the one that infringed. So Cookson sends a low one inside forward 50. That was a poor kick though, so Stead came in and took the diving mark. And Greensboro have it again on centre half back. They've got a few runners out the near side. Stead decides to go long up the line. Ridewood had front position, got two hands to it. Out the back is Mullins, does a nice goose step around one, tries to handball off to Rogers. Rogers at ground level spits a handball out. Looks like it's Cookson again who dived upon that one. In fact, it was Daniel Kelly. And there'll be a ball up on centre wing near side of the ground. No score yet. 6 minutes gone here in the first quarter at War Memorial Park.
Big men get up, and it is Finn who gets down and wins it to ground level, trying to pursue the footy now. Going in hard there is a player there for Greensboro and Callaway. He was set upon by three or four Heidelberg players, and we will have yet another stoppage. Same position on that wing in front of the scoreboard here at War Memorial. It is Finn who wins it down once again, only as far as Fowler, who tumbles one inside forward 50, picking it up cleanly there with Stanton. Did well, got it to Riddle, he couldn't take it cleanly. Now he's wrapped up after he gets the ball again, but he gets it back to Stanton. Stanton gives a handball off to Fowler, who started it all, and he finishes it off in style.
Great chain running there by Greensboro. It all started with Stanton. His clean, I guess, pick up there was that in turn allowed his players to run forward of the ball, and Fowler, the man in the right place at the right time, and he was never going to miss the classy player running into to 40 metres out, and a lovely shot on goal. It's going to be a tough day to kick the goals. Very heavy ball, very soggy conditions, but Matty Fowler showing his class there. Getting Greensboro on the ball there, one goal straight, six. Heidelberg yet to score. We've gone 7.25 minutes here in the first term. The game coming to you from War Memorial Park.
Good running goal there from Matty Fowler. Converted that one directly in front from 40 metres out. And the restart from the middle goes the way of Greensboro. The handball out to Callaway. Took a nice pick up. Callaway wearing the long sleeves today. Looks out around the wing looking for Stanton. Stanton pushed out of the contest. Heidelberg might get it here through Curtin. They do, but he's taken it over the boundary line.
Plenty of stoppages and throw-ins to be expected today. Any defender just happy to get that ball out of bounds and allow his side to just restart, get numbers back again. And interesting that Curtin's the man for Stanton. Stanton, you just see, he's got him a fraction for height there, doesn't he? I think it's a matchup that Greensboro potentially might look to isolate.
Hooper wins it down. Stellis, who was going to be the first one there, got blocked off by Pianto. Hodgkin handball out into space, but now Greensboro got a handball chain going through to Callaway. Callaway to Boyden. Good grab there by Reese Boyden. He can put through Greensboro's second in a minute.
It was a great kick, wasn't it? Just kick to the space that he wanted Boyden to lead to. They opened up that fat side of the ground, got the transition there. Important midfielders are involved there. Stead again got a hand out, and it's been a good start so far for Callaway as well, and that was a lovely kick to find his teammate up the field. A chance for Boyden now from 35 out on a 35 degree angle.
Big Boydo, we know he loves putting them through the big sticks, and how much the Greensboro faithful loves his good work when he does kick straight. This time, has he done it? Yes, he's put it through.
That minus score.
Oh, no, he's put it off to the left. Sorry, my apologies.
So Greensboro 1-1-7, Heidelberg yet to score. About to go for a restart. We'll go around the grounds quickly, where we've got Montmorency off to a good start. 2-2-14. North Heidelberg's one behind, and Northcote Park with the first goal against McLeod. 1-1-7, McLeod yet to score.
9 minutes gone. The kick out from fullback finds Coulson at right half back. Coulson very much the Ty Vickery lookalike as he goes long up the wing. Hooper had front position, didn't go for the mark. Decided to double fist over the boundary line for a throw-in.
Greensborough supporters even getting in the act here, just beeping the horn as right at the important moment as he goes to kick as well. So the 23rd player, I guess, to speak of today, certainly the crowd, the Greensborough faithful do love to get around their team.
9 minutes gone, 7-0. Greensborough in the lead. Hodgkin handballs that one out, looking for Gaylard. He was tackled in the contest, and they swing one back inside forward 50. Greensborough coming out to meet it, though, was Curtin. Did very well, barges way through two players and sends that one tumbling up towards centre-half forward. Pianto scoops it off the ground, handballs off to Hodgkin. Dummies around one, handballs out to Cookson. He's seen a lot of it so far. Up towards right half forward, no mark taken there from Gaylard. They get it on the rebound. Looks like he was clocked by his teammate coming through.
Yeah, friendly fire.
Yeah, it was Bauer. Probably copped a boot to the head. There'll be a ball up at right half forward.
Slow to his feet, but the main thing is he is up and he looks okay.
Right on the perimeter of 50. Ball comes down. Back out to Luke Hodgkin this time. Handballs outwards to Cookson. Swings around on the left. Tumbles that one towards the forward 50. No mark taken. They have numbers here, though, Heidelberg. Pianto's in there, as is Sergeant. The umpire calls for it. 45 metres out, just right of centre in the forward 50 for the Tigers.
10.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. It's Greensborough 1-1-7, leading Heidelberg, yet to score. Ball in the Heidelberg forward half. Going up there is Finn, winning it down off the back of the contest. Matty Hyde, he kicks one that pitches just inside the boundary line, and it will be thrown in once more.
Just smart. He knew what he wanted there, the boundary. He did it in a way that it didn't look too obvious or too deliberate, but Matty Hyde, such an experienced player, as we said, defenders today always looking for that boundary just to give their teammates a chance to reset in their defensive end. As Hooper won that tap down, the ball's moving nowhere though, and we'll get a secondary stoppage. Nearly 11 minutes now tick over. Greensborough with the only scores of the game, they're 1-1-7. Heidelberg get the score.
It will be Hooper once more, and a beautiful tap out the back, got it down into the path of the man in Ireland. Now the ball at ground level being picked up by Kieran Andrew. Got slung straight away, but he was able to get it off to Gaylard, who goes long towards the goal square, looking for Sergeant off the back of the contest. He might be the first one there, and he is the first one there. Kept his feet, socketed off the ground. Heidelberg's first goal.
And I guess that's the importance today of communication in defence. Going to be a hard day to kick goals from any range, but you're looking for all the cherry-picking goals you can get. But Sergeant, the only player who stayed down there, two Greensborough defenders went up in the air, and once the ball hit the deck, well, it was easy pickings for Sergeant, who kicks a goal. Important one, I guess, to get his day started and get his side up and going as well. Their first real deep forward 50 entry, and they're able to convert. Heidelberg, one goal straight, six. Greensborough, 1-1-7. 12 minutes played, first term here at War Memorial Park.
The Sarge has a goal. First for the day for Heidelberg. 1 point the difference. Greensborough leading. 11 minutes gone as Greensborough get the clearance up towards half forward. Coming through Grubb, first time we've seen him today. They've got Miller playing on him. Miller gets hands to it though. Grubb has him in the big bear hug tackle. The ball spills out. Play on advantage. Stead inside forward 50 for Boyden out the back. He just waited. Ridewood had the early jump and he just let it fall into his arms.
There's a lot of speculation around the sling tackle at the moment. Obviously things have happened in the AFL, but a great tackle there by Grubb. He picked Miller up, but the important thing is he didn't dump him into the ground. He twisted him, ball came out, didn't throw him down, and that great tackle really opened up the play, didn't it? The ball got central. It was a free kick, the advantage played, and Boyden now the beneficiary, shooting at what would be his first goal.
150 goals for Reece Boyden in his career. Could he make it 1-5-1? Yes, he can. Reece Boyden has the second goal for the day for Greensborough and his first for the afternoon.
So the fast reply there for Greensborough, 2 goals, 1-13. Heidelberg, 1 goal straight, 6. Conditions, well, boys, are not too bad. It's certainly improved since an hour ago, but expecting more rain to come throughout the day. Any early goal worth its weight in gold as we go around the ground. Lower plenty, 2 behind. West Preston yet to score. Montmorency's 4-3, 27. North Heidelberg, 1-1-7. And Bundoora, 1-1-7. Eltham, 1-2-8. That game, of course, Geelong Reserve.
Here we go again in the middle here at War Memorial Park. And it is McNamara who's gone to the ruck now, and he wins it down into the path of Hodgkin. He paddles the ball out in the area of Andrew. Couldn't pick it up cleanly. Stellis could. Stellis goes inside 450. Boyden, almost another mark. Off the back of the contest. Going to have to be good here. Curtin, he worked it towards Rybwood, who gets one close to the boundary. Does it stay in? No, it just pitches before the line and then rolls out for a boundary throwing.
Only gone 14 minutes, but Reece Boyden looking really dangerous, isn't he? He just couldn't get that one there at his shoelaces. He's kicked 1 goal, 1, and they're really getting him deep, trying to isolate that matchup on Jack Rydewood.
Regardless of the weather, Reece Boyden can still take a good mark as the ball is thrown in. About 50 out from Greensboro's goal. Hooper taps that one inside 50. Fowler came through. Might spill here for Rogers if he can pick it up cleanly. He does, but he fell over. De Stelis swings that one towards goal. Curtin got a fist to it. It'll go across the face. Heidelberg avert danger momentarily. There'll be a throw-in in the fourth pocket.
The importance now of getting Tim Atkins into this lineup as well. He's doing the ruck move at the moment. Allows Hooper to have a rest, and you think it points throughout the day that Hooper's going to push forward. We saw it back on Good Friday where Hooper went forward for just 10 minutes, was able to kick two goals, and here's Stanton doing the ruck work as well. We've got so many players who are multi-talented, aren't they? And Atkins, just another great pickup for this club, returning after a couple of years at Mernda.
Extremely versatile. The tools in this Greensboro setup, and it is Stanton, one of those versatile tools, winning it down. And as far as McNamara, wrapped up by Stelis, another stoppage. Greensboro forward half, about 20 metres out from their goal.
14 and three-quarter minutes gone in this game here. Greensboro still leading as the ball just spills around their 40-metre area. The ball sent high in towards the forward pocket. Boyden underneath it. As was McNamara, couldn't take the mark. The ball's going to spill out towards the pocket, and that one's just gone out of play.
Like that by McNamara, getting back, getting in front of Boyden, just giving Rybood that extra support.
Probably need that today from a few of their tools as the ball is thrown back in. It's 5 metres around, coming through Stelis, taken the ground immediately by Luby. Was he without it?
It's paid the free kick in the back.
Yeah, it was in the back against Michael Luby, and that one's going to go to Andrew Stelis. And Greensboro will have another shot at goal. He'll line up from about 35 metres out, Andrew Stelis, the former Bundoora player.
They've been ultra impressive from the throw-in, haven't they, so far, Greensboro? Boyden had his shot at goal earlier. I know he missed it, but that was a fast break from a throw-in that time there. Stelis just hit the pack with such pace, and Luby, well, he had to make the tackle. Unfortunately for he just rode into the back of Stelis, who's generally a nice shot at goal. Stelis is lining up for what would be his 48th career goal. Of course, a former Bundoora player, premiership player in 2014. Stelis, a shot on goal. Looks pretty good. The Borough have a third, and they're out to a handy lead early in this first term. 3 goals, 1:19, the home side. Heidelberg, 1 goal, straight 6. Impressive start, and 3 goal kickers already for the Borough in the opening 15 minutes of this contest. Around the grounds, Division 2, Laylaw, 2 goals, 3:15, leading Hurstbridge, 4 behind. Diamond Creek off to a good start, 2 goals, straight 12 to Patton Hill, 1 behind. And Whittlesea, well, they're flying out of the gates. 4 goals, 1:25, Mernda has not scored.
Did Stelis play in Bundoora's 2013 flag as well?
No, he wasn't a member of the Bundoora Premiership.
Just the 2014 Premiership. Still good enough, though, for Andrew Stelis. One more than me. As the ball comes down from the middle, Pianto has his man in a bear hug, and there'll be a second stoppage in the middle of War Memorial Park.
He's been a revelation, though, for Greensboro. He was a fringe player at Bundoora. He'd certainly get a game now, but he just couldn't crack what was a really strong forward line there, and he's come to Greensboro and just added another dimension.
Atkins punches that one down. Perry collects, goes back to Atkins, sweeps that one out wide to Mullins on the right, up towards half-forward. Greensboro moving it very nicely, but the kick from Mullins was too heavy. There'll be a ball in 55 out.
They've been a lot more clean, haven't they, in this first quarter?
Yeah. Well, it's not quite danger signs yet for Heidelberg, but Greensboro certainly on top. You can see now Paul Bauer has already just gone back, filling the hole at the moment, the loose man in defence. I think they recognise that they just have to slow this game down quickly here, because if it goes as it is, the game could be over really early. I think it's an important move to get Bauer back.
Could have another mark here, but Bauer does very nicely. We're just speaking about him. Takes the mark as a loose man in defence, and Heidelberg can restart.
They need a big effort from Paul Bauer here today, and here he goes with a long right foot kick. Yeah, there was the right option. He found Coulson, who did very nicely. He didn't infringe in the back. He just used his body very well to get his direct opponent out of the way. And here he is, Coulson, at right half back. He goes long, trying to find his man over the top there in Sargent, but there were plenty of Greensboro numbers there, belting it out of bounds.
I think that's good coaching there by Craig Hunter. Recognise that, I mean, it's only a 13-point ball game, but recognise the danger signs early on. Just get an experienced player back to settle the situation, and he was straight into the thick of the play. It was an important move, and I think you can already see quickly that Stelis has now run to Bauer. Obviously, Ben Turner doesn't want Bauer roaming loose, but Heidelberg now have that loose with Luby playing as that spare man.
3-1, plays one straight, 18 minutes gone. Greensboro with the lead. They lead by 13. Almost just 2 minutes away from the time on here in the first quarter at War Memorial Park. Ball thrown up on centre wing. That one hits the ground again. There'll be another stoppage.
Chance to go around the grounds. Division 3, South Morang 3-2-20. Banyule 1-3-9. Watsonia off to a flyer 4-9-33. St Mary's just the 2 behinds.
Ball thrown up. Fowler just pinballing that one around with Pritchard. Centre wing comes out to Cookson again. He had his handball smothered, and now Greensboro can get it through the middle. Here goes Stead. Sweeps that one out to Hyde. Hyde on half back. Back over the top to Stead. They work it very nicely on the 1-2. Now Stead hugs the boundary line with that kick. Finding Stanton. Stanton was sandwiched between two Heidelberg players, and he took the mark. It was a great kick from Stead as well. I think he's just a little bit beyond his range here. Luke Stanton is definitely looking inboard.
McNamara's got back here, filling the hole for Heidelberg.
There's a few short options if he wants. Decides to go long to the square. Has he gone for goal here? It's a long kick. Has it got the accuracy? I think it does. That's a brilliant goal from Luke Stanton, beyond the 50. And that's another goal for Greensboro.
That is an absolutely sensational kick. I was actually about to criticise him, saying he's gone long to Boyden against three Heidelberg defenders. I thought it was a wasted kick, but it just kept going and going and going. And the drop punt from outside 50, Luke Stanton, sensational effort. Greensboro now off to an absolute flyer. Four goals, 125. Heidelberg, one goal straight six. How about that smother from Nick Riddle at the other end of the field?
Sensational. Set it all up. But Luke Stanton, he's a funny old player, isn't he? He looks like at times that he could absolutely rip this competition to pieces, showing serious form with efforts like the previous one, that goal from 55 metres out on the boundary.
I reckon his best game for Greensboro was about the grand final last year. He was sensational grand final day, working as a foil to Tim Bongetti. And he's had some injury concerns this year, but he's a key to this Borough lineup now. There's no doubt about it.
Atkins and then Nick Riddle working his way through the midfield. He tumbled one up to half forward. Bauer was the first one to get there. He just sockers it off the ground. And it was a precision little ball there, rolling out of bounds right in front of the interchange gates. It will be thrown in by the boundary umpire again.
They've got to respond quickly here. They were in an opposite situation, weren't they, last week? Actually led McLeod 25-6 and it went awry from there. But they'd understand that they're still well in the contest, but they have to respond before quarter time here. You feel they must kick the next one.
Atkins won it down. Plenty of players around the footy at ground level, one of which was the man in Perry, who got a handball out into a little bit of space. Still plenty of numbers here. And Atkins couldn't quite keep it in, so it will be thrown in once again. Same spot right in front of the interchange gates.
Time on here. Greensboro 25, Heidelberg 6. Ball to be thrown in near side of the ground. Thrown in, tapped out the back of that pack. It just spills to ground level. Coming through, I think that was Gaylard. Again, the ball is trapped at ground level, and they have another stoppage.
I mean, both sides now have that loose man. Luby playing it for Heidelberg, and Matthew Hyde for Greensboro. I mean, Hyde reads the play so well. I know it's early days, but you don't want him loose all day across that Greensboro half-back line.
Calloway went in hard, couldn't pick it up. Hodgkin could. He tumbled it out towards his teammate there, who couldn't pick it up, but eventually it rolled to Alan Young, who gave it back to Luke Hodgkin, who kicks long towards half forward. Good one-on-one contest. Curtin brought the ball to ground. Now going in is Pianto. He gets it back to Hodgkin. He's been involved three times, but a brilliant tackle. And he was wrapped up, and it's going to be a free kick. It's going to come all the way back. Deserving effort it was there by Josh Calloway, and now he's got it at half back. Looking for options further afield, decides to go laterally and finds Perry. He's got it at half back, now switching to the other side where Matty Hyde, that man you were just talking about, sets up, distributes so well for Greensboro on every occasion, just about every week. He's in the best. Now Nick Riddle's got it. He goes over the top. His kick's not going to advantage his teammate there in Calloway. Good mark taken here at half back. Heidelberg reload.
So Ryan Stone now, central kick. It's a dangerous one. Hangs up for Pianto, who's strong overhead, though. The pressure there was coming from Matthew Fowler, but he took the strong overhead mark. He's got a man on the outside here. This is Bauer, centre wing. He can get and go quickly, Bauer. He looks to do that, but he can't get around the man on the mark. So he's off his line, but the man on the mark is not coming at him. That's Perry. And now Bauer finally gets around him. He waited for Perry to come at him. His handball, though, was a dangerous one. Got it to Jared Hodgkin, who was really good under pressure there. Long left foot kick, but it's going to be turned over. A diving Matthew Hyde didn't take the mark, but controlled it. Now an underground handball, and they were almost out. Fowler's handball was smothered. Shot on goal. Well, it was a loose man in the goal square. And Heidelberg, well, against the grain of play, it wasn't pretty, but they've got a goal on the goal. They couldn't quite pick up who that man was.
It was Stone after he got it from Alan Young, who made a brilliant interception.
And a bit of a to-do afterwards as well. A few bodies go sprawling on the goal line. But Stone gets one. He kicked four goals last week. It was a match-high four goals against McLeod. And he's got his side an important one here. We hear a whistle now. It's going to be a free kick off the ball. I can see an umpire pointing to the centre square. And I think it might be a Greensboro free kick from the restart. It is. Michael Hooper's got the ball. Went to hand. Well, umpire said no, we'll have to go over the line here, over the mark, I should say. And well, it was a momentary, I guess, a bit of confusion going on. It is Greensboro here leading 4-1-25. Heidelberg's two goals straight, 12, and take two, and Michael Hooper now gets the ball.
On the right boot, he goes up towards half forward. Perry takes it on the chest. Young 20-year-old in his first game for the Borough goes over the top. His kick went through the hands of Coulson, but Heidelberg again equal to it. Here goes Andrew, kicks that one towards the boundary, dribbles out of bounds. There'll be a throw-in inside 50.
Four goals, 1-25 Greensboro, and Heidelberg two goals straight, 24 minutes gone here in the first quarter here at War Memorial Park. Throw in over the head of Finn. Pick it up and clearing it out is Kelly. Gets it out into a bit of space, but there are Greensboro numbers that are going to get to the ball first. The two that are going to get there, Pritchard and Calloway, they're going to be the couple. And they work nicely together. Now McLinden getting involved. And now a long kick up towards half forward. Good effort by Stellis to get front position, but Luby did really nice to gather the ball, but it was turned back over. Now Stellis to Rogers, and Rogers high and long into the Stanton direction. Off his hands, it's going to be Calloway. He goes inside to full forward, probably not his best kick either. Stead fighting hard for it at ground level. He's wrapped up straight away by Kelly again. And there will be a stoppage deep inside the Greensboro forward half in the forward pocket.
Might have been Nash Cullen, and they're laying the tackle there on Stead. It was an important one to lock that ball up. Skirting on the outside there was Josh Grubb, just waiting to pick one off there, but he did well, Cullen, to lock it up and get a stoppage.
Ball thrown up. Finn punches that one towards the line. Rogers chases after it into the mud, and over it goes. Down to Trump.
So we've gone now nearly 25 minutes first term. Greensboro with a good start, 4-1, 25. Heidelberg, two goals straight, 12. Did respond with the last goal through Ryan Stone. The margin was 19 points before that. Now back to 13. Umpire balls it in. Give that one probably to Finn, but it's Rogers at ground level. Work through traffic. Got a handball out. This is Doherty now. High up and under. It won't be 15. It was touched. It's going to be a free kick to Heidelberg, surely. Cullinan had his shirt held there by Stead, and he gets the free kick across half back.
Deep in defence, Cullinan flares that one to the outer side. Bauer takes a mark and uses the outside runner in Hodgkin. Touches that one on the ground. Careful with the left foot kick up the line. He goes just towards the 50, but a good intercept mark taken by the co-captain, Matty Hyde. He's done very well in that contest, and he centres the ball. Finds Cataldo as the rain begins to start again, just light. Cataldo waits on half-back. Goes backwards and finds Nick Riddle standing at centre half-back. And they come out the near side. So they've completed the switch successfully. Here goes McClendon, takes off the centre half-back. On the right boot, goes up towards half forward. Coming in from the side though, Curtin took a very nice defensive mark. And so just a bit of back and forth here between the two sides. Curtin goes back out wide. We're doing circle work. Luby marks it left half back.
They've just contained things, haven't they, here, Heidelberg? They've done it well. They've just slowed down the run. Greensboro had, as you said, opened up that 19-point lead. But the last 5 minutes have been controlled. They've got the goal. Now just content to hold the footy. Just stem the tide a bit. It's experienced play by the Burgers.
Miller goes long, but only as far as Brent Ryan, who's been able to intercept at half back. And he goes on with it straight away with a bit of run. Tries to lace out Josh Riddle. But Luby, once again, playing a bit of kick-to-kick there, those two. And now Luby can release Andrew, who's running away from Hooper. He got a little bit of contact from him after he delivered the ball. Kick up long, but McLinden was there with the fist. And he punched it out of bounds. Boundary throwing again.
Good as a kick, that spoil, wasn't it? The double fister went a good 25 metres, found the boundary line. Closer and closer here to quarter time. A goal either way would be huge in this contest here. 25 plays 12. It's Greensboro, the home side, with the advantage. Nice bit of ruck work there by Finn. Found Gaylard, but it's going to be a free kick. It's going to go against Finn, is it, for a high infringement against Hooper. Reached over the top there, and umpire spotted it. Michael Hooper now with a free kick on centre wing.
It's Hoops. He's looking further afield for any potential options he may be able to kick to. Stellis is making a handy lead. And Doherty's also made a nice position there, just 20 metres further forward of where Hooper was.
Oh, neat.
But now he dummies around very nicely. Gets around Luby, chips it up in the Riddle direction. He was in good position. Now ground level, Kieran Andrew. He swings it around the corner towards the boundary. Is it going to stay in? It just pitches inside. It's a perfect kick.
Heidelberg with all 18 players in their defensive half at the moment. Greensboro's got a few players set back with Hyde, Ryan, and also Nick Riddle just waiting back. But Pianto, the only man etching even close to the halfway line for Heidelberg here as they lose this clearance. Centering ball, numbers back though. They should clear here, Heidelberg. If Stone can be clean, he was. He thumped the ball that way towards the boundary. But as you can hear in the background, the siren has sounded. And at quarter time, it is the reigning champ with a handy buffer. 4-1, 25 Greensboro at quarter time. Heidelberg, 2-12. The goal kick as well. There's singles all round. And for Greensboro, we've got Luke Stanton, Matthew Fowler, Reese Boyden, and Andrew Stellis, all with singles. For Heidelberg, a goal each to Chaz Sargent and Ryan.
I'm just not sure how Heidelberg's going to kick a winning score if Greensboro can maintain their intensity.
I thought Greensboro's mids won that the battle in the first quarter. I think Heidelberg got it on, started to level it up as the quarter went on. I thought Jared Hodgkin had a really good first term for the Tigers, but they need more from that midfield brigade. I know they're undermanned a fraction. They're coming up against a really solid midfield as well. complemented by two good ruckmen in Hooper and Atkins. Probably Goods underselling them as well, but I think Heidelberg certainly around the stoppages have to win more ball than they did in the first term.
Start of the second quarter, 4-1, 25 Greensboro to two straight, 12 Heidelberg. It is Mick Finn who gets it down from the first hit out of this second quarter. Matty Fowler just tumbles one up towards half forward, eventually lands in the arms of Stead. Stead gets it further afield, and that was precision movement out of the middle. And as you said just before this quarter started, they need a lift out of the midfield, Heidelberg, but they didn't get it straight away. Greensboro once again using the ball brilliantly. Now it's Josh Grubb who is on the end of it, and he is a sharp shooter. You'd back him from just about anywhere, Josh Grubb. On this occasion, he's wobbled it. It probably wasn't his best effort. It just floated through the air eventually in the arms of Mick Finn, who takes a nice mark, intercept mark at fullback. He goes with the handball to Kieran Andrew, but probably wasn't the right decision there. There was pressure coming, and Andrew was hampered by his direct opponent from Greensboro. Ball ushered over the boundary line.
Well, Mick Finn might go into defence. We know he's a good overhead mark. He's gone deep in defence. There's going to be a throw-in 5 metres around from Greensboro's goal in the back pocket. Ball thrown up, tapped down front and centre. Greensboro desperate to get hands to it, but the ball spills out Heidelberg's favour and goes towards half-back. So they got the clearance, but it goes out again for a stoppage. Might have gone out of bounds on the full.
Yep, out the full. Yeah, Stead ball.
Just pitched out of bounds, so it'll be Tristan Stead at left half forward. They go back inside Greensboro. Can they take a clean mark? No, they can't. Atkins looks like takes it on the half volley. In fact, that was Josh Riddle. Handball up and over. Heidelberg getting numbers back again. And that one's been locked up at ground level. Oh, it's been given holding the ball. So Cookson at ground level has been pinged for holding the ball. Could have gone either way. For a ball up or holding the ball, really, but from the result of that means Lockie McCorkin, the co-captain, will have a shot at goal, left half forward, just on 50, bombs that one long to the line. Don't think he'll have the distance, had the accuracy, and there's been a mark.
Free kick to Boydon.
Ah,
chop of the arms, bit of a hold in that marking contest in the goal square, and it will be Boydo who's going to be able to put through his second goal of the afternoon.
There you go.
So from point blank range, Boydon makes no mistake. He becomes the first multiple goal scorer, and Greensboro have the first goal in the second quarter. They go to 5 goals, 1-31. Heidelberg, 2 goals straight, 12. A couple of free kicks there, the last to Boydon. He's looked really dangerous, hasn't he? He's been able to win the ball by himself, and on that time there, he's the recipient of a free kick on the goal line.
Yeah, and that came from serious pressure on the last line of defence, and then when Heidelberg were trying to exit their back 50, they couldn't do so with any calmness or surety or time, and good intercept marks taken there by Stead and McCookin, and eventually a goal to Boydon.
So 5-1, plays two straight, 19 points the difference. Heidelberg from the middle, Kelly had an air swing at it, taken to ground. And the umpire's given away a free kick. So it's going to go the way of Kelly of Heidelberg, defensive side of the circles. Taking his time, Heidelberg up to rush numbers inside the forward 50. Looking for Hodgkin, couldn't take the mark, got a hand to it. They kick it inside 50 off the ground, but there were numbers back there for Greensboro, so they account for that one nicely. There goes McQuillan, handball to the outside now. I think that was Doherty, in fact that was Ireland, goes up towards half forward. Grubb, looks like Coulson's gone down off the ball, holding his wrist, so keep an eye on that one. That's going to be a stoppage. Coulson is definitely holding that left wrist.
Yeah, no, he's not might be
the
way.
I think it's the shoulder, actually.
That'd be a huge blow for Heidelberg today. They need him if they are any chance of taking down this Greensboro outfit today. They're already lacking tools. Now the ball on the outer side of the ground. Picking up is Luby, sidestepping around Stead, then handing it to a teammate. Long ball up towards half forward. He's going to pitch just inside and roll out of bounds. Any update on Cookson? Oh, sorry, Coulson.
Well, the two trainers have gone to him. Certainly that left shoulder, it looks to be. So he almost just walked straight to the boundary on the far side of the ground to just walk straight off. He realised what he was going to do, the error of his way, and he's now standing on the ground and running across. He obviously would get impeded with a penalty by crossing the line not at the right place. So he's off the ground now as McClendon heard the voice behind him, handball to Hyde in his defensive goal square. Had to be quick there. Jared Hodgkin was applying fierce pressure, and in fact it was Luke Hodgkin, and Hyde rushes it behind, so it's a minor score, 2-1-13 Heidelberg. Greensboro's 5-1-31, and the short kick out finds Nick Riddle, who now releases Adrian Cataldo.
Cataldo, right half back, goes long up towards centre wing. One-on-one contest underneath it. Stellis did very nicely, took a strong mark. Defensive side of centre, goes up the line, finds a teammate further afield. This is Rogers. Cuts inside on his left boot and goes long inside, forward 50, to a one-on-one contest. Miller was there, got a fist to it, out the back, Ridewood cleans up, looking for Andrew, has to pick it up off the ground. Again, Greensboro with plenty of numbers forward, they're so much cleaner, more alert to the ball. And that one's going to be balled up just on right half forward, just inside the boundary. Greensborough's front third of the ground. Ball thrown up. Hooper taps that one down. Heidelberg get the clearance, sorry, up towards centre wing. It'll bounce once in front of Luke Hodgkin and Nick Riddle, I think that was. And that one's going to go out of play. Centre wing near side of the ground here at War Memorial Park. Greensborough 5-1-31. Heidelberg 2-1-13. 18 points of difference. Round 13, Division 1. Live on your local station, 88.6, Plenty Valley FM.
So, one down there by Finn on that occasion, and now the work there by the Greensboro fellas. Pritchard involved, gets it to McQuilkin. McQuilkin now with a high up and under pressure. Mullins will be the first one there. He got hands to it, couldn't take the mark, but he goes back in. Then maybe wrapped up when he didn't have it. He's at the bottom of the pack. Umpire says, holding the ball, he didn't try and get it out. So it will be a Heidelberg free kick at centre half back.
So Heidelberg with the footy.
Gaylard, it looks like.
Again, there's very few options forward. So Gaylard has to go sideways and finds a man on the outer side. Mark taken by Miller. Plays on the wing. Goes long up towards half forward. A target underneath, out the back. A good run onto it here. It's Will Knight off the ground. Kicks towards goal. And he puts it through. Heidelberg get their first goal of the second term.
So Will Knight, the opportunistic goal. Probably got away with one there. Umpire blindsided, but got into the back of his opponent, but he was good enough at ground level. It was a fair soccer because he was well outside the goal square. He needed a kind bounce, and he volleyed it from mid-air, and classy finish there by Will Knight. All three of Heidelberg's goals coming from the ball just getting at the back and being able to run onto it into an open goal face. But that margin, well, it cuts it back to a 12-point deficit. So Greensboro, you feel in control in general play, but on the scoreboard, Heidelberg sticking with them, 3-1-19. Greensboro 31-19, and we've gone 6.5 minutes in the second quarter. We'll have a secondary stoppage after the first. Didn't move any further than half a metre.
I think in these conditions as well, it's always going to be a bit of a risk on the scoreboard because it's always going to be so tight. Here go Heidelberg.
Hodgkin up to half forward. Good mark taken, and they can go further afield, and they decide to. They play on long inside forward 50, almost taking the mark there was Sargent. Now ground level, Pritchard is able to pick it up, gets it to Riddle. Riddle gave it over to Ireland. Ireland dribbles one towards the boundary, but it wasn't his best kick. It was out of bounds on the full. He couldn't quite get the dribble going. He tried to, but it was on the full. The ball landed, and a lovely little drilling ball there from Hodgkin. Laces out Sargent. This is a tough kick, though. He's 50 metres out, right up on the boundary.
It's a good mark. Very good mark. A very good kick as well from Luke Hodgkin. Luke Hodgkin, one of their better players last week, I thought.
Mercurial player, Chase Sargent. Do we think he can put this one through?
I hope he can. It'd be a great goal. Right foot kick on the way to the goal square. Didn't have the accuracy. Decided to go for a target. No one took the mark. Ball hits the deck. Again, top of the goal square. Heidelberg inside forward 50. So Sargent,
his reaction said it all there. He threw the head back as soon as it left his boot. He knew it wasn't on target.
Ball up inside Heidelberg's forward 50. Finn taps that one down. Pianto's roaming. Can't grab it. Umpire says we'll have a secondary stoppage. In a dangerous position here for Greensboro. Heidelberg only two goals behind. They're right in front of Heidelberg's goal. Ball thrown up. Third man over the top was Nick Riddle. Ball spills out the back. It'll be picked up. Pianto almost tackled his man to ground. At the back there, looks like it's Ireland. They'll get it back though, Heidelberg. Handball on to Hodgkin. His kick was smothered. A great smother there from Fowler. They might get it back though. Heidelberg desperate now. Here goes Bauer, tackled to ground. There'll be a stoppage. So Greensboro just survived that little scare.
So Irving wearing the back to his number 28. He, of course, had to have the number change last week. Bauer left his jumper at home, forced the change. The ball now slapped inside. Here's a chance for Knight. Ran into Irving there. And the crowd want a free kick. And it's a hole in the ball free kick against McQuilkin. In fact, it's Hyde. And the free kick goes to Charles Gaylard. He's almost on a horizontal with the goals here. But he's looking confident to go with the drop punt. Gaylard arcs around here. Shot on goal. It's going to be a 50-metre penalty. A 50-metre penalty because Fowler infringed on Sargent there. And Gaylard now goes right to the goal line. And for the first time today, Heidelberg's going to kick consecutive goals.
And they'll be back within a goal. And this game will be back on again.
So wait for the ball to come back.
Wait for it to retrieve. Of course, Gaylard's shot did go wide there into the cricket nets. It's finally been retrieved to Gaylard. And from point blank range, he makes no mistake. It's a one goal ball game. Heidelberg, 4 goals, 1:25. Greensboro, 5-1-31. Game on here as we go around the grounds in Division 1. beginning at Bill Laurie Oval, where McLeod's kicked three consecutive goals to take the lead against Northcote Park. 3-3-21 Northcote Park, McLeod 3-4-22, Lower Plenty 4-5-29 leads West Preston, 4-straight-24. North Heidelberg 3-2-20 trails Montmorency 7-6-48, and Bundura 2-5-17. They lead Eltham 2-3-15. Ball now back in the middle here at War Memorial Park. We've gone 10 minutes in the second term. It is Greensboro leading by an even kick.
Here goes Mick Hooper and Mick Finn once again, the two Mickeys. There's a bit of a neutral one. Ball didn't convincingly get one by either ruckman. Mick Finn picks it up at ground level, wrapped up straight away. Another secondary stoppage right in the heart of War Memorial Park.
So Hooper doing the ruck work. Gets the tap down for Greensboro. No clean hands to it yet. Heidelberg get it there, and then it's going to be a ball up. The ball hasn't really moved at all. It's in the centre here of a muddy War Memorial Park. Over the top, Hooper taps that one down. And when kicked out of the square, goes up towards half forward. McClendon was a bit apprehensive getting that one down low. Coming through there was Ireland. He was not apprehensive at all. Crashed into the pack, taking the ground. There'll be a ball up. In the right half forward corner of the centre square.
They've just locked the ball in their forward half for the majority of this second quarter, and I think that's helped them turn the tide. They haven't done too much exciting or extravagant. They've just locked them in their forward half, and it's allowed them to get opportunities.
And they go again, Heidelberg, inside forward 50, but Brent Ryan was equal to that one and took a mark inside defensive 50. Well, from the last inside 50, when Hodgkin kicked it to Sargent, they locked it in there for a good 3 to 4 or 5 minutes. Greensboro, rebound out of defence. Here goes Cataldo on the right boot, kicks that one up the line. Luby will get there first, but the boundary line beats them all. This will be a throw-in on centre wing here at War Memorial Park.
Go around the grounds. Division 2, Fitzroy Stars, 2-6-18 lead. Thomastown, 2-5-17. Hurstbridge is just breaking clear of Laylaw, 6-7-43. Laylaw, 2-4-16.
This time it is Hooper, who wintered down only as far as Stone. Going in is Perry. He got wrapped up. It's another thing they've done a lot better in this quarter. Whenever one of the key players for Greensboro has been able to get first hands on it, the tackling's been a lot better.
Yeah, their application's certainly been better in this second term than it was in the first. Did get into a game-high lead of 19. It's back into 6, 31 plays 25. Greensboro still with the advantage. Mullins dives on that one, and that might be contact below the knees, I would have thought. It will be. It's going to go to Gaylard. The reason that rule's brought in, I guess it's one of those 50-50 ones there. The old folk don't like it. They love the man going in first, getting the ball, but that's the reason the rule's brought in, is Hyde dropped one overhead. Now Will Knight on the boundary line. Can he work some magic? No, his handball's going to be turned over at ground level now, and the umpire calls for the ball. 60 out from the Heidelberg goal, kicking to the clubroom end of the ground in this second term. They've kicked the last two goals. And a chance again here as the ruckman go at it. McNamara won that one down, but it was of no real advantage, and the umpire will call for it again.
Heidelberg in the last few minutes have just overtaken Greensboro for this quarter in inside 50s. 6 inside 50s to 4. They've had the ascendancy in the last couple of minutes. Ball thrown up from McNamara. Taps that one down to Cookson. Inside again they go. No mark taken, but over the shoulder free kick. Luke Hodgkin will get it. And Heidelberg with this set shot will have the opportunity to level it up. It's 5-1 to 4-1 at the moment, and Hodgkin on a 45-degree angle here at left half forward, right in front of our commentary box, can level the game up here halfway through the second term.
That's the importance of playing in front, isn't it? It forced Hyde to reach around there, and in doing so, the umpire said it was a high spoil, so a chance here. Luke Hodgkin to level proceedings. Shot on goal was always missing near side. Sneaks it in for one behind. And the margin now cut to 5 points. Heidelberg 4-2-26. Greensboro 5-1-31. It's going to be Nick Riddle to bring the ball back into play.
Here's Riddle at fullback. Right foot kick long in the direction of Atkins and Stanton, who's presented up the ground. He can't get his hands to it. Heidelberg going to re-enter their forward 50 again. Tumbling one into Pritchard. He's got to be clean. He was. He did very nicely. Good tackle there from Pianto. But Atkins is able to clean up here for Greensboro. Kick out towards Bauer. He's the only one there. He's going to have to sidestep his direct opponent in Ireland. It was a great tackle by Ireland and Mullins. And it should be holding the ball. He took him on. And it is paid holding the ball in the end. Well done, Ireland.
So Ireland, the young man, will have the ball just defensive side of the wing. Outsmarting the former AFL player, Paul Bauer. Ireland goes up the line. Good mark taken overhead as well. That was Josh Doherty, former old Ivanhoe player in the VAFA. Kicked this one up the line. Greensboro trying to be clean with it, but that mark was dropped, but there's a free kick given. So Greensboro still retain possession. Jordan Perry, Northern Blues player. His claim to fame, playing with Chris Judd for the Northern Blues. As the ball goes up towards half forward, Jeremiah taken out the back?
Yeah, it was.
Heidelberg's weight. So Alan Young across left half back. Back up from whence it came up the line. Doherty in a one-on-one contest, marking contest, got a hand to it. Out the back, Pianto handballs that one forward to Hodgkin. Hodgkin tried to get a handball away, but Doherty came in, affected it. Tried the interception. Umpire's going to call for it, and there'll be a ball up. So that ball didn't really go anywhere in the end.
Really like the work of Hodgkin and Pianto in this quarter. Both of those two have been inspiring their team and trying to match it with the likes of McCook and Stead and Mullins, who were so good in that first quarter.
Atkins taps that one down, front and centre. Looks like Doherty again coming through. Pritchard sweeps around the back of that one. Hacks that one forward. It's just going to go out of bounds on the full as well. So Heidelberg will regain possession. In the last minute or two, it's just been a lot of back and forth on this near side between Heidelberg and Greensboro.
Can't spot Coulson on that Heidelberg bench at the moment, guys. So I don't want to say anything premature. You can't see him out on the ground there either, but he might be in a bit of strife. Obviously, that left shoulder that he hurt earlier in this turn. They've actually played a lot better since that incident happened. More just a coincidence, not as a direct result, but he's gone off, and they've obviously gone a fraction shorter, but they might be down to 21 for the rest of the afternoon with no sign of Coulson at the moment.
Free kick, Luby takes it, touches it on the ground once. We'll go across centre-half back and to the outer side. Boyden almost got a hand to it. The kick was a bit heavy though. Andrew just gathers inside the boundary line. Handball's over the top to Miller. Miller wants to go back to Andrew, decides against it, kicks up the line again, out of bounds on the full. This time it's against Heidelberg for Greensboro. It'll be a free kick, centre wing outer side.
Both sides doing well to force their opposition numbers to kick the ball under pressure. Seen plenty of out in the full so far today in this first half. Long kick from Cataldo up into a dangerous area where McQuilkin, with serious courage, is able to take a mark while he had Jake McNamara bearing down. He gave it off to Stead. It kicks long to Stanton. Almost a great mark there taken by Bauer. Now at ground level, going to have to be clean. He couldn't quite do it. He got ridden into the back. Umpire said no free kick. Oh, Stellis gave a handball to Rogers. Rogers snapped one towards the goal, but relieving mark taken there on the last line by Mick Finn.
Yeah, it might have been Ridewood at centre-half back as he comes out the near side. Sergeant, mark went through his fingers, diving after that one. Calloway paddles it over the line. And there'll be a ball in. That's 65, 70 metres around from Heidelberg, from Greensboro's goal. Just forward of centre wing on the near side of the ground. It's going to be thrown in. It's going to be Atkins doing the ruck work, and he got the tap down as well. Stellis paddled it forward. And they're taking the ground again in that similar position, right half forward.
Around the ground, position 3, Heidelberg West 2-3-15, Reservoir 10-2-62. Also got St Mary's 2 goals 4-16, Watsonia 6-11-47.
5 points of difference, 17 and a half gone here in the second. Hodgkin is the first man to take clean possession out of that stoppage, and his high kick is met with a magnificent mark. Again, some courage there from Cataldo, who went back with the flight and was met with contact, but he still hauled it in wet conditions. Tough thing to do. He goes up to half forward, tries to get it to Stellis, but some nice body work from his direct opponent, Kieran Andrew, holds him out of the contest, and now Hodgkin can sidestep, dummy a couple. Now he gets it into Stone, who's at centre-half back. He switches across, tries to find his teammate in Bauer, and Bauer's got it now. He kicks over the head of the teammate he intended for. It was touched off a couple of Greensboro hands and then eventually landed in one of his other teammates' hands, but he was at ground level and was set upon by two or three as soon as he got the ball.
Cataldo could be in the votes today. He's been great on halfback.
Sensational.
Another good mark just a few moments ago. The ball is on the centre wing, out of side, thrown up. There'll be a second stoppage. That one went nowhere. 18 and a half gone, 5-1 plays 4-2. Greensboro with a 5-point advantage. Ball thrown up again, whistle. From that back, it's going to be a Heidelberg free kick. So they stand with the ball, 60 metres out from their goal. A long kick from McNamara, inside forward 50, looking for Sergeant, who flies in from the side, off hands. McClendon does well enough. Sweeps around the back and puts a handball forward again to that man, Cataldo. A beautiful kick. Finds Stanton on the chest. Again, outnumbered 2-1, but he did very nicely. And Stanton goes over the top, finds Rogers on the edge of the square. Cuts inside, left foot, looking for Perry, who was clattered into the back. Good sprawl over the top, though, from Heidelberg. They might get it back. Andrew put his body on the line. Tried to paddle it forward to Cookson. Again, they're paddling the ball around. But again, Perry cleans up. Delivers inside forward 50. On the lead. No mark taken. Good sprawl out from behind. Here goes Grubb. On the right boot. Kicks that one towards goal. Goes across the face. No score at all. And Ridewood marks. And Heidelberg are away from defence.
He read it very nicely, Ridewood. Now he delivers out to half back. Mark couldn't be taken by the Heidelberg man out there as well. Done by Pritchard to bring it to ground for Stead. Stead long into Riddle. Josh Riddle taking a nice uncontested mark after the turnover.
Opposite foot kick there, superb by Stead. Importance of being able to kick both feet. He was caught on the left. He's still able to get the ball 40 metres up the field and nail the pass here to Josh Riddle. And he can go back and kick at Greensborough's second goal for the turn. They did lead at quarter time by 13 points. That margin's been now eroded to 5 points. This to end the run of two straight goals for Heidelberg. Riddle coming in now. Approach on goal. He chipped at it, but it went straight and it went through the big sticks. And Josh Riddle has his first goal for the afternoon. Greensborough respond and the margin goes back out to 11 points. Greensborough 6 goals, 1-37. Heidelberg 4 goals, 2-26. We've just ticked into time on here in the second quarter. Around the grounds, Division 1, Northcote Park 3-4-22. McLeod 6-5-41. Lower Plenty is 4-5-29, leading West Preston 5-1-31. North Heidelberg closing in on Montmorency 5-2-32 to 7-6-48. And Bundoora 4-6-30 leads Eltham 3-3-21.
And back here in the centre of the ground, it's Atkins and Finn, and it's Finn who wins it down to himself and then rows his own work, but his kick was under a little bit of duress, and it lands in the arms of Matty Hyde at centre-half back. And now he can go long into the direction of that man again, Riddle, who gets the jukes up and second grabs it again. He's starting to warm into this contest nicely now, Josh Riddle. Such a handy inclusion for this Greensboro juggernaut since their premiership last year. He's been brilliant, Josh Riddle, since he's come into their side. He goes long to half forward. The Bowers, the man there waiting in the hole at half back, takes a mark and then switches across to the other side of the ground. McNamara is the man who receives in front of Nick Riddle, and now long up towards the wing, looking for Stead. Looking for Curtin, but Stead was there first. Now going in hard is that man Curtin, and also his mate Will Knight. Will Knight inside the forward 50. Oh, great spoil over the back. It was going to be an easy mark to Ryan Stone, but coming over and intercepting over the top, the Greensboro man made a magnificent spoil, and he's now down and sore and hasn't got up yet.
He's paid the price, hasn't he? Nothing malicious at all by Stone. They ran for the footy. Did get into the back here of the Greensborough defender. I didn't quite pick up who was it that came across. I thought it was Josh Grubb originally, but he's obviously not talked on a defender, so might have got my wires crossed there. But getting to his feet now, very slowly, Matthew Fowler. And you probably don't expect anything less from Fowler, as he actually makes his way from the ground now. He'll be a sore boy, got one through the ribs there as Cataldo now takes the ensuing free kick.
Rebounds out of defence up towards left half back. No mark taken. Greensborough with numbers. They arrive to the footy. Right in front of the camera position, just beneath. There'll be a ball up on the right half forward here. We're about 55, 60 metres out from Heidelberg's goal. Far side of the ground. Gaylard tries snapping that one out of the pack. Taking the ground there. Pianto wrapping his man up in a tackle, so there'll be another stoppage.
11 points of difference with 22 and a half minutes gone. A late goal here would be crucial either way.
Over the top, Atkins just let that one bounce off his shoulder. High kick up from Perry. It's intercepted by from Luby. So Heidelberg get possession back, and the tempo has just slowed down a little bit here. Luby on centre wing. Wants to pump this one long, and does. Up towards right half forward. Good mark out in front, taken by McNamara. In fact, that's Mick Finn, the big Irishman. Turns around. He's got Will Knight calling for it across centre half forward. Decides to go further inside the forward 50. At the back, Nick Riddle got a fist to that one. And it's just going to be carried over the boundary line out for a throw-in.
23 and a quarter minutes played in this second quarter. 2 goals apiece for the term. It's Heidelberg 4-2-26, Greensborough 6-1-37. Umpire now brings the ball back into play. Atkins to ruck for Greensborough. Got front place there. Didn't really tap it. It was more the ball hit him in the end, but he's scooped one at the back here perfectly to Matthew Hyde. And he kicks long, more in hope than anything. Hooper was his target, but Michael Finn got across, took the intercept mark here for Heidelberg on centre wing. He's got Gaylard screaming for the ball in board. It would have been a dangerous kick. Instead, opts the handball off to Andrew. His kick inside was always going to be cut off, and Matthew Hyde takes the mark for Greensborough. Looking for the switch now. The ball goes wide for Cataldo, who'll mark on his chest and go straight away. Didn't like his options up the field, so decided to go back off his line. Can go to McClendon over the top. Took a fraction long there, so now he's forced to go long down the line. 50-50 ball, getting up and taking a fine mark over the top. That's Doherty.
Mark of the day.
Right in front of the coach's box. If you're going to take a mark, best place to take one, I reckon, right in front of the coach's, but his kick was poor, and it was spoiled out of bounds there in the end. That was by Cookson, and we'll have a throw in centre wing with Greensborough leading 37-26.
Did all his good work with the kick there, Josh Doherty. Ball thrown back in under the grey skies here at War Memorial Park. Certainly clouded, blanketed by the clouds. Hasn't rained though since the reserves game earlier, so the rain has held off. Ball to be thrown up here, centre wing, near side of the ground. Atkins underneath that one, taps that one forward. Not much of an advantage though. Andrew came through. Again, he's been one of Heidelberg's better in and under players so far this afternoon. Really putting his body on the line. Ball to be thrown up again, centre wing. Greensboro, they lead by 11, current margin. Up towards centre wing, hook and kick around the boundary line, up towards half forward. Boyden stuck a fist over the top, couldn't get hands to it though. Coming through, Josh Riddle just gets it out, but he's been given holding the ball.
Yeah, incorrect disposal that one. That was dropping it.
So Kelly has it, handballs backwards to Bauer. Heidelberg most certainly playing a bit slower at the end of this second quarter. Bauer kicks that one long up the line, looking for Sargent. Again, though, it's Greensboro with all numbers back. Heidelberg's forward thrusts have been pretty meaningless in the second half of this second quarter as the ball goes up the line again from Greensboro. Underneath it, Finn couldn't take the mark, dives after it. Stellis, his pursuer.
Holding the ball again, so they've been hot in the whistle here. Game just being played between the two half forward lines at the moment. There was four Greensboro players waiting for that ball when it fell off Sargent's hand before. Not one Heidelberg man there, but the Heidelberg numbers are back here and they're contesting this one. Here's a chance though for Hooper. He couldn't get to the ball. Heidelberg now with numbers in defence. They should clear their lines. Come out to Luby here, who turned to his left and went back to his right. He kicks long up the line. The ball hung up in the air. Hyde got across with the spoil. Sargent now wins the foot race, but the boundary line beats all comers in the end. And we'll have a throw-in at centre wing. 26 and a quarter minutes played in the second quarter. Greensboro 6-1-37. Heidelberg 4-2-26.
Late stages here in the first half. And Miss Hooper who wins down that rap contest. And it is the siren. After that ruck contest, and it is, as Sam said, Greensboro 6-1-37, leading Heidelberg 4-2-26 here at the main break.
So it was two goals apiece in that second term. Heidelberg kicked their two goals through Will Knight and Charles Gaylard. And for Greensboro, Reese Boyden kicked the opening goal of the quarter. And they had the bookend goals, didn't they? Because they did kick the last, and that was through Josh Riddle. Entertaining first half, hard footy to win. The conditions, well, they've been kind to us so far, it has to be said. It's not pretty, but it's much better than was forecast. And we have a ball game at half time with Heidelberg trailing by just 11 points. Margin did get out to 19 early in the first quarter, and we thought we might be in for a one-sided affair, but Heidelberg certainly responded, and they're taking it right up to the reigning premier. We'll go around the grounds and we'll begin in Division 1, where we have McLeod. Will have kicked the last seven goals of their encounter against Northcote Park. The Cougars are 3 goals, 4-22. McLeod, 7-6-48. Lower Plenty, 4-7-31. Leads West Preston, 5-2-32. North Heidelberg's also 5-2-32, but they trail Montmorency, 7-6-48. And Bundura, 4-6-30. Leads Eltham, 3-3-21. In Division 2, Hurstbridge, 7-8-50. Leads Laylor, 6 goals, 4-40.